22 is Rusty Webb. Adam Tolliver in the 28 and the double zero machine of Ruben Mayfield coming to the green flag. Green flag is out of way underway with heat race number one, taking the top three finishers in this eight-lap heat. Greg Martin down the back straightaway with a rocket ship underneath him. He'll move now into turn number three. He's looking to lead lap number one is the driver of the 24 M machine, Greg Martin. He's going to lead lap number one. Second place is going to be the 9 of Zach Cease. He is in the second spot, followed by Pierce McCarter. And then in the number 25 machine, it is Bobby Mays, the driver. In that TNT race car entry into the fourth position. So right now, the transfer spot is the 71 machine of Pierce McCarter. Two laps now in the books. Three laps to go that time by. Greg Martin still your race leader. He is pulling away. He was one of those drivers when we came here in April who had a great car, finished second in that main event. Jake Tinkle was third. Corey Hitchcock was your winner. Halfway cross flags displayed for the books. Four to go here at Smoky Mountain Speedway. Still the 9 in second, followed by the 71 of Pierce McCarter. McCarter into that third position, then Bobby Mays in fourth. Out front, though, it is still the 24 of Greg Martin. Martin still our leader, and he is pulling away by about 15 car lengths, making about 20 now. He is at a rocket ship underneath him. Of course, he barely missed that quick six dash, qualifying seventh earlier on in the night. Pierce McCarter still holding that transfer spot. Of course, we will have a B main. We'll have a B main coming up to fill out the rest of our field. White flag in the air for Greg Martin in the 24 machine. Cotton Eye Jones out of Knoxville, Tennessee on the right quarter panel of that machine. Looking through turn number three for the final time. Here comes Greg Martin off the corner. Greg Martin, Risco Industries checker flag. He'll grab heat race number one over the 9 machine of Zach Cease. And finishing in the third spot is the 71 of Pierce McCarter. Bobby Mays will finish fourth. He'll go to the B main. Also, Rusty Webb in the 22 going to the B main. Adam Tolliver going to the B main, along with Ross White all going to the B main. The second heat is staged up and ready to go. Glad to see that news as we'll be part of the JT Kerr Memorial there for 5,000 to win. Coming up June 8th, we'll be at Crossville June the 7th. And of course, we got Mayhem in the Mountains going on. Here we go, heat race number two out on the Speedway. Rookie of the Year competitor presented by Terrier Race Cars. That is Clay Coughlin going to bring him down. Another Rookie of the Year competitor beside him, Bradley Llewellyn. Another Rookie of the Year competitor. There's a theme there for the top four. Eli beats the 14-year-old competitor in that Capital race car. Shannon Emery in the 52, the Phillips Motorsports entry. Jeff Newbert in the 40th edition machine. Greg Husky in the 61, driving for Mr. Kenny Ford. And Josh Walker, another rookie, all in his heat. Top three will advance in the second heat. PP on the hood of that 52. Eli beats in that 109 machine. Looks like he's having some issues on that machine. He'll fall to the tail of the field. Clay Coughlin, CBR chassis, left front shock possibly on the 109 for Eli Beats. That thing is chattering. It was chattering in one, chattering down in three. He'll make the left-hand turn down into the pit area. Clay Coughlin still your race leader, followed by Bradley Llewellyn. Jeff Newbert in the transfer spot. Then it's Shannon Emery, followed by Greg Husky. And, of course, the driver making his inaugural start here tonight for the American Trade All-Star Series, Josh Walker in the 2 machine. Halfway display to the field that time, 4 in the books, 4 more to go. Horrible break for Eli Beach. We'll see if he'll be able to work his way through the B main coming up. Oh, the six of Clay Coughlin, slow on the front straightaway. Problems for the former race leader as he is slow down in turn number one. That will hand the race lead now off to Bradley Llewellyn. Jeff Newbert will now move to second, followed by Shannon Emery in third. Clay Coughlin going to limp it back around to the pit area. So two of the favorites in this heat, including young Eli Beats. And, of course, the former race leader, Clay Coughlin, has pulled down into the infield. Stinger race cars on this tin machine. That is the chassis of choice for Bradley Llewellyn, one of our Terrier Rookie of the Year competitors who is leading this heat race and looking to transfer into the dance to $2,000 in main event here tonight at Smoky Mountain Speedway. Bradley Llewellyn going to dive down into turn number three for the final time, running that middle groove. Llewellyn now off the corner through the Smoky Mountain Rad starter box. He'll take the Risco Industries checkered flag, and it's going to be Black Magic Bradley Llewellyn, followed by Jeff Newbert in the 40th edition and transferring in the Phillips Motorsports entry PPM on the hood of that machine, Smoky Mountain Wraps. It is the 52 of Shannon Emery. So those three drivers will advance now to the dance, the main event for the American Crate All-Star Series. Heat race number three out on track here for the American Crate All-Star Series. In the 5J, that is Jesse Lode, his outside, Deke Waters in the 66. And the third starting spot is the 68 machine of Andy Ogle, the CVR race car entry in the B00 machine out of Newport, Tennessee, in the TNT race car. That is Josh Henry. Michael Smith in the 15 out of Crossville, Tennessee. Brett Hall in the 109. And Austin Lane, that is your field. Green flag is out, and we're underway. Remember, three drivers will transfer into the 2000 to win main event here tonight. We'll go to Clay Valley Speedway tomorrow for our first ever event there at that facility, a beautiful brand new dirt track, formerly Lonesome Pine, which was an asphalt facility. And then we're going to replace it on Sunday for $5,019 with a possible purse double if we can have 50 cars signed in, and it's very possible. We have 35 here for night number one. I believe we've got about 37, 38 of them already confirmed. So if we can pick up a few more drivers on Sunday, we might be looking at a 10,000 arena being possible up at Whip Raceway. As we turn back now to the action out on the track, of course, he is in front of the field. Jesse Lowe in the 5J machine is out front over the 68 of Andy Ogle, but we got a great battle for the transfer spot. The 66 goes high, almost into the wall. It'll open the door. The driver to Crossville, Tennessee in the 15 machine, Michael Smith, is now up to third. Josh Boo Henry looking for fourth. Deke Waters now the 66, a Little Caesars machine now falling back to the fifth position. So now move Josh Boo Henry up to fourth, the driver to Newport, Tennessee in the TNT race car entry. Here comes Deke Waters, the 40 back on the inside. Slide job, Deke Waters now back to fourth. Boo Henry on the outside, still hanging on the edge of the quarter panel. Austin Langley in the Ford machine, choosing to dive down into the pit area. He has retired from this third heat. Out front, though, it is Jesse Lowe. He'll zip by the Smoky Mountain Rat starter box down the front straightaway. Back into turn number one. Should be coming for two laps to go this time. Popsicle Sticks should be out and waving from Mr. Ralph Muncy. The 5J of Jesse Lowe working through turn number three with about a 10-car length advantage. Back to Andy Ogle. Ogle still in second. And here in the third position is Michael Smith in the 15. Deke Waters in the 66. Josh Boo Henry and Brad Hall all on the outside looking in. White flag is in the air from Ralph Muncy. Jesse Lowe going to see the white flag. He's looking to advance to the main event for $2,000 here tonight for the American Crate All-Star Series here in heat race number three. Gonna back straightaway, he'll dive off into turn number three for the final time. Jesse Lowe, Risco Industries checkered flag. Jesse Lowe will win heat race number three and will transfer to the main along with Andy Ogle and Michael Smith. Going to the B main will be Deke Waters in the 66, the double zero machine of Josh Boo Henry, and the 109 Capital race car entry for Brad Hall. So heat race number four, please be ready. Heat race number four, be ready in the staging area, please. who's going to transfer out of this one. You got some heavy hitters, including Aaron Gwynn, Anthony White, Tyler Collins, Chris Chandler, who always runs really well here at Smoky Mountain Speedway. The driver there out of Weaverville, North Carolina, in the TNT chassis. Side by side, recommend stack up. Green flag is out, and they move the left through the Smoky Mountain starter box. Looks like everything is clean and ready to go. A little bit of contact back through the field. Everybody trying to gather it up. The 97 of Aaron Gwynn looking to the outside of the 11 of Tyler Collins. Collins on the inside. Gwynn on the outside. Right now, coming back, lap number one, the 29. Bollinger is a your race leader, but here comes Anthony White. White looking on the bottom of the speedway. Adam All in the 7 in the 3rd and the transfer spot up the 6 machine. Maybe a little bit of contact with the back straightaway wall there. For Sonny Husky, but he'll keep it going. Just slight contact. Great battle between the 97 and the 8 for that 4th spot. Chris Chandler all the way down in no man's land in the infield. He is searching all around the speedway, trying to find some grip. As this track now starting to dry out just a little bit. The 29, Rusty Bollinger in the 29 machine. Still with the lead halfway displayed, Anthony White in second. And then, of course, the rocket chassis of Adam in at 7. Adam All now around Anthony White. White with problems off the corner. Anthony White in the rocket chassis is stopped here on the front straightaway pretty much, and a caution is out. Yes, he has a right rear flat there for Anthony White, the driver out of Clinton, Tennessee, in that rocket chassis. Field side by side now working through turn number 3, the 29, going to bring them down. Aaron Gwynn to his outside. Green flag is out. Rusty Bollinger in the 29. Caution is out. I believe we've got a jump on the start. So a warning being sent out to the 97 of Aaron Gwynn for firing before we get through the starting box. He was up beside the 29 before we was able to get through that area. So we will get a verbal warning via the race receiver, and we will line them back up. Everybody behind the 29 machine will go double file for 29, all by his lonesome in row number 1. Rusty Bollinger in the 29 machine, still with the race lead, followed by the 97 of Aaron Gwynn and Adam All in the transfer spot in 3rd, but he is feeling the pressure as he has Chris Chandler to the inside. Chandler not going away easily without a fight. He is right there inside the left quarter panel, and lurking back behind them is the driver out of Indiana, Tyler Collins, in the 11 machine. White flag in the air. The 29 with about a 6-car length advantage over the 97 of Aaron Gwynn. The 7 machine of Adam All fighting to make his way into the main event later on. Coming off the quarter checker flag, it's going to be the 29 machine getting the win, followed by the 97 of Aaron Gwynn. Rocket chassis there for Adam All will finish in 3rd. Chris Chandler. Chris Chandler in the 8. We'll go to the B main. The 11 of Collins, Tyler Collins, will go to also the B main, along with the 6 machine of Sonny Husky and the 2 of Anthony White. Rusty Bollinger in the 29 is your heat race winner, heat race number 4. Next up will be our quick six dash, and then I believe we will take a little bit of a break, and then we'll come back for our B main action to set our remainder of our field. Good quick little drive. We'll be headed down to Brasstown, North Carolina, to Ray Cook's Tri-County Raceway. And then on that Saturday, we will be going to Blue Ridge Motorsports Park on June 15th. So the 13th, 14th, and 15th. This one will be in action. We'll go Georgia, North Carolina, Georgia. Here we go. Phantom Racing. It's quick six dash underway. Six laps, little cash in hand going to our winner, and it will set our top six starting spots for the main event here. Oh, Tyler Arrington climbing a hill. He had to get on the binders. He almost got into the back of the five machine of Caution is out, and oh, there's right front damage on Tyler Arrington's machine. The 83 of Jensen Ford, the TNT House car, gonna lead him down. Solo style out front. He'll come to the Smoky Mountain Rats. A starting box, green flag is out. And we are back under Corey Hedgecock, who started sixth in this heat, is now up to second. Followed by the five machine of Mark Weiner. They call him the Magic Man. He is out of the great state of Florida. He is in that third spot. Also, Stinger Race Car entry, that 73 machine. Trevor Cease in the 73 in fourth. And then it is Jake Teague out of Wartburg, Tennessee, in that fifth spot. So the 83 of Jensen Ford trying to be a repeat winner here with the American Great All-Star Series. We've had three events, three different winners. Well, tonight be the night that we have a repeat happen. Jensen Ford, still your leader, followed by Corey Hedgecock, and then it's the five machine. The driver out of Middleburg, Florida, Mark Weiner in a five in the third spot. Be main competitors, remember, you need to be working on those cars. We will have a bike races, some other festivities that are going to be going on here tonight. So please be having those adjustments, have them made, and ready to rock and roll. Here in just a few short minutes, Risco Industries checkered flag. Jensen Ford, UTV Outfall, getting the job done over the 23 of Corey Hedgecock. Followed by the very right icon entry for Mark Weiner, the driver out of Middleburg, Florida. Trevor Cease finishing fourth. And Jake Teague out of Wartburg, Tennessee, in a Longhorn chassis, finishing the end of the fifth spot. Course six will go to Tyler Arrington, who had a horrible break with some right front damage on his machine. Hopefully he is able to get it back out for the main event. That'll be main number one. Here we go. Green flag is out. The 25 of Bobby May's going to lead him down into turn number one. Deep waters in the 66. And then it is old Josh Boo. Henry taking all the way up to the wall. The 25 of Bobby May still leading into deep waters. Then it's Adam Tolliver in the 28, and then it's Ross White, and then it's the 22 of Rusty Webb, then Josh Boo Henry. New Valley Furniture putting up, I believe, $100 for our B-Main winners throughout this Mayhem in the Mountains weekend. Also want to thank the new sponsor coming on board, Bush Builders Incorporated as well coming on board. So I want to thank New River Valley Furniture and Bush Builders Incorporated. Of course, New River Valley Furniture putting up $100 for our B-Main winner. And Josh Boo Henry having a bad night here at Smoky Mountain. The front end of that machine caved in as he is battling back for that final spot. Out front, though, it's all Bobby Mays in the 25. Bobby Mays, still your race leader in that TNT race car. Entry the driver to Jonesboro, Tennessee. Then it's Deep Waters in the 66 machine in that second position. Of course, that is the transfer spot. Adam Tolliver in the third spot. Of course, remind everybody once again, of course, it's a 20 grand points for 5,000 for the winner of our overall points championship at the end of the season. And man, it is laced with incentive bonuses at each event with hard charger awards from the hard charger award, of course, from QA1. One thing also, the winner of each event gets a $50 gift certificate from Olin's as well. Checkered flag, it's going to be Bobby Mays getting it done. So $100 going to Bobby Mays, courtesy of New River Valley Furniture, as he will pick up the win. And also, Deke Waters in the 66. Deke Waters in the 66 will finish second, and he will transfer into the main event as well. Great Lake Model drivers, as soon as limited is done with five laps to go, you need to be in the staging area completely lined up for your 30-lap feature, and sportsmen need to do the same and follow. Field now side-by-side, rack them and stack them through turn number three. Who's going to transfer to the dance? We're going to take two cars out of this being made, and then two provisionals, and that will seal our 24-car field. Remember, the drivers that do not make the show, which there'll be 11 of those, will get that tow money. We'll get that tow money as long as they compete in these B-mains and competed in the rest of the festivities for the 61 of Greg Husky on the inside, Chris Chandler on the outside. Josh Walker in the two, not making the call here for this B-main. Green flag is out. The 61 of Greg Husky with the lead. Here comes Chris Chandler on the outside like a rocket ship. He'll shoot by Chris Chandler to the race lead in that TNT race car entry. Here comes Tyler Collins, a driver out of the Indiana. Oh, all over the 61. Did he have to get on the binders quickly? Did Collins, what a save. That'll move Eli Beats in a 109. Oh, the 11 of Collins is around, and we've got two of them that have lost the wheel.
Here in the left rear,
I've never seen that. That's a whole rear end six. The whole rear end, the axle is out of the six machine of Sonny Husky. So the 8 of Chris Chandler going to be your race leader, followed by Clay Coughlin, Eli Beats, and Anthony White. Who's going to make it in this one? We're down to four. Starting box, they've made their way through it. Clay Coughlin in the 6 and in that third spot. Here comes Anthony White. Anthony White looking for third now. Eli Beats in the 109. In the second spot, followed by Chris Chandler. Only taking the top two in this one. Limited late model drivers, please be ready. Limited late models, please be ready. The 8 of Chris Chandler still. Twitter followed by Eli Beats as he is in the transfer spot. Clay Coughlin in the 6 and then the 2 of Anthony White. Eli Beats looking to the inside of Chris Chandler for the race lead. Halfway to Splane. The 8 of Chris Chandler, followed by the 109 of Eli Beats, followed by Clay Coughlin. Coughlin in that third spot. Chris Chandler still up front. That TNT race car, followed by the 109, that Capital race car entry there for Eli Beats. Here comes the CBR race car entry for Clay Coughlin out of Pigeon Forge, Tennessee. So the top three drivers now under a blanket. Remember, only two transfers, so things could get interested if Clay Coughlin can get to the 109 of Eli Beats. Anthony White hanging on in that fourth spot. Chris Chandler in the eight, working through turn number three. White flag in the air. White flag, and then it's Eli Beats in second. Clay Coughlin in third. Coughlin trying to race his way into the main event. Coming through the corner, checkered flag, Risco Industries, checkered flag. Who's it going to be at the line for second? It's going to be Eli Beats. Clay Coughlin had to settle for third. Anthony White, fourth. And New Valley Furniture, $100 going to the eight of Chris Chandler for the B main win. Field being told via the race receiver. Go ahead, tighten them up. Here we go. Double file. Rack them and stack them. $2,000 on the line. Jensen Ford on the inside. Corey Hedgecock on the outside. And they will go wheel to wheel, side by side, mano a mano here for this 30-lap main event. Green flag is out. If I get to the Smoky down our abs, the starting box, green flag, and Corey Hedgecock is shot out of a cannon. He is gone. The 83 of Jensen Ford now back to the second spot, followed by the 5. Mark Watery out of the 5, the driver out of Florida in the third position, and then the 73 of Trevor Cease. Oh, we got problems. Corey Hedgecock, the race leader, slow at the bottom of the speedway. Corey Hedgecock's chances of going back-to-back here have went up and smoke and evaporated. He'll dive to the infield. We'll stay clean and green out on the speedway. Jensen Ford, when we were here in April, he had problems and did not have a competitive night. He has now assumed the race lead. Mark Weiner in the 5 for the Magic Man in second, followed by the driver to Warburg, Tennessee in the 117 and Longhorn Racing Chassis. That is JT. Trevor Cease in the 73. And rounding out your top 5 is the 24 of Brett Martin. Then it's Tyler Arrington, Brad Llewellyn, and Jesse Lowe. Up front, we'll turn our attention back to the 83 machine, the TNT house car for Mr. Jensen Ford. Ford, a winner at Tazewell Speedway to open our season for the American Great All-Star Series. But the driver from Florida who made a long trip up here is running in the second position. Nothing to cut hole in the Magic Man, Mark Weiner in that second spot, followed by the 117 of Jake Teague in third. Great battle back through the field as they continue to battle. You have Eli Beats and Shannon Emery going toe-to-toe. Chris Chandler, oh, the 7 and the 2 getting together. What a great save by both of those competitors. Anthony White going to move his way around the 7 of Adam Hall. Jensen Ford leading that, the line, followed by the 5 of Mark Weiner. Everybody's still clean and good to go out on the racetrack. They will be getting into lap traffic here momentarily. The 66 will be the first car that will be in the path of the race leader. That is at Deep Waters in that 66 machine, sponsored by Little Caesars. Still the 83 of Jensen Ford, your race leader, followed by Mark Weiner in the 5 and every Icon machine. And it's Jake Teague, Trevor Cease, Greg Martin, Tyler Arrington, your top 6 out on Speedway Battle for 7th now. Jesse Lowe to the outside of Brad Llewellyn. Llewellyn back back on the inside, fighting with Jesse Lowe. Lowe on the outside, inside, outside, into back and forth between Bradley Llewellyn and Jesse Lowe. Lowe gonna finally, I believe, gonna wrestle the spot away, but not yet. Almost down in the infield with Bradley Llewellyn. He'll fall back behind Jesse Lowe now. The 66 of Deep Waters. Bobby Mains at the tail of the field. So Josh Boo Henry is already out of this event along with Corey Hedgecock. And Jensen Ford with problems down the back straightaway. Ford now falling to the inside of the speedway into the pit area. So problems for Jensen Ford. The Magic Man will assume the race lead. Mark Wider in the five with the race lead. So if you've been the leader, it's not the place you will be here in these first 11 laps. First, it was Corey Hedgecock falling victim. Now, Jensen Ford falling victim. Mark Weimer in the 5, senior race leader of the 117 and 18. And it's Trevor Cease in the 73. And it's Greg Martin and Tyler Arrington. Jesse Lowe creeping up into the mix as well. Deke Waters now, maybe about 10, 15 corners in front of the race leader, so lap traffic is definitely going to play a factor in this one. We've got 13 laps complete, going to be coming back to 14 this time. Sportsman drivers, be ready, sportsmen. Need you to be ready, sportsmen. Be ready. Water, the Magic Man with the race lead over the 117, the Longhorn chassis here, winner Warbird. JT gets second. Deke Waters going to go a lap down. He will give way to the race leader, the Magic Man, and the very hot icon entry, Mark Wadner. 15 halfway in the books, halfway home. Coming back to lap number 16 now. Number 16 here for the America Great All-Star Series. It has been an eventful main event. We started off with Corey Hedgecock, who was trying to go for a back-to-back victory. He picked up the win, took off with a race lead, and then had problems and broke on the back straightaway. Jensen Ford going to send the race lead. He also took the same fate and broke and went into the infield area. That handed the lead off to the Magic Man out of Middleburg, Florida, in the 5 machine. Barrett Icon entry for Mark Weiner. But here comes the 117 of JT. Bobby Mays in the 25 on the inside. The race leader, Mark, the Magic Man. A Weiner going around him. Here comes JT trying to cut through traffic as well. He is in the second position, followed by the 73 machine of Trevor Cease, and then it's the 24 of Greg Martin. Here comes Jesse Lowe. Jesse Lowe, the man on the move. He's been on the march just trying to pick him off as we went out through this main event so far. Later, just starting to get bottlenecked up behind a couple of lap cars. The 7 of Adam Hall directly in front of the race leader. Mark Weiner in the 5. Still your race leader. Of course, the jump off set out of Middleburg, Florida, leading the field. And a bear out icon entry. Then it's a Longhorn chassis for the 117 of JT in that second spot. Then it's Trevor Cease, Greg Martin, and Jesse Lowe, your top 5. Laps are starting to flip away. We're starting to get down to the nitty gritty. We got 22 of them on the board. 30 going to be the distance. Sportsman, be ready. Sportsman competitors, fire them up. Have them ready. You'll be going for your main event as quickly as possible. Look at Chris Chandler right there in front of the leaders. He was hustling around the high side, still trying to stay on that lead lap. All of these competitors, including Adam Hall, Shannon Emery, Jeff Newbert, and the 8 of Chris Chandler. And that is really starting to bottleneck up the field. Bradley Llewellyn with problems out on the speedway. He is slow down the front straightaway. Will he make the left-hand turn into the infield? Yes, he will roll into the infield. We will stay green with lap number 24. has retired from this main event. The leaders, though, are mired in lap traffic as they are lying in front of the leaders. The 52, the Phillips Motorsports entry. Shannon Emery fighting hard to stay on the lead lap along with Jeff Newbert. Adam Hall has now won a lap down. That has brought the top two drivers together as the five of Mark Weiner, the Magic Manual Race leader, followed by the 117, J.T. And now 117 in second, but Adam Hall has found something on that high side. He's trying to unlap himself as he has went past the 117. He's going to unlap himself and go by the five. So the seven of Adam Hall going by the race leader. He'll pass also Shannon Emery, so he'll unlap himself, but he's found something on the high side, and he's picking off position after position. The Magic Man, Mark Weiner, on the inside, trying to bottom feed Jake Teague in the 117. Contact between Emery and Mark Weiner. That's going to open the door to high side for Jake Teague. Teague on the outside. He's going to hustle that outside groove at Jake Teague in a long horn chassis lead change. Jake Teague going to take the white flag. He will look to go back to back. He won at Warburg last Saturday night. Jake Teague in a 117 long horn chassis. We talked to him a little bit earlier in the pre-race Facebook show. It's going to be Risco Industry checkered flag. Jake Teague going back to back. He'll become the first ever back to back winner here for the America Great All-Star Series. The Magic Man, Mark Weiner, going to finish in that second position. And then it's the 24 of Greg Martin, then Jesse Lowe, and Trevor Seat's going to round out in your top five. But race fans, how about a last lap pass? And I'm going to tell you, I think he learned it all from Adam Hall in that seven. He went to the outside and unlapped himself around the leader. And the 117, I believe, followed suit and seen what happened. So if you went to the top and you figured something out, how about the 117 of Jake Teague? He is your feature winner here tonight, $2,000 richer, once again for the America Great All-Star Series here at Smoky Mountain Speedway.